अस्सलाम वालेकुम, आई एम डॉक्टर ज़ाहिदा परवीन, पीएचडी इन स्पेशल एजुकेशन एंड वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन, लोअर माल कैंपस, लाहौर। दिस इज़ द कोर्स ऑफ टीचिंग ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स टू मेंटली चैलेंज्ड चिल्ड्रन। This course belongs to Masters in Special Education and the area of specialization is mentally challenged. The code of this course is SPED 4139 and this is a course of 3 credit hours. The title of today's lesson is Objectives of Teaching Mathematics. In this lecture, we will discuss major objectives of teaching of mathematics. The agenda of today's lecture is objectives of teaching of mathematics, and in this slide you can see 5 basic objectives of teaching of mathematics. It includes problem solving, reasoning and proof, communication, connections and representations. As we know that all students require more rigorous mathematical knowledge and skills in order to pursue higher education, and this is the world of technology, and to meet the needs of this technological world, it is very important to gain the skills and knowledge of mathematics. And for this purpose, on a very basic level, on the level of school education, it is very important to give the understanding of different basic areas of mathematics to the students. Fundamental areas includes arithmetic, measurement, geometry, probability, data analysis and statistics, algebra and functions, and they must develop proficiency in mathematical skills. All of you are well aware of these all fundamental areas of mathematics. Because all of you have must read mathematics up to 10th class, 10th grade, because it is a compulsory subject, and all of these fundamental areas are included in the school education mathematics. Arithmetic includes basic maths like addition, subtraction, division and multiplication. Measurement, you all know about the measurement units. Similarly, geometry, geometrical shapes, probability, it's a concept of statistics, data analysis and statistics, and then algebra and functions. In addition to these all fundamental areas of mathematics, what else the students need to learn is the variety of methods and tools to compute. Like, students must know about how to use paper and pencil for the mathematics, mental arithmetic, estimations and calculators. Mental arithmetic means when we use our mental skills to answer the questions without the use of paper or pencil or without the use of calculators, and we mentally compute the question and then we answer. This is called as mental arithmetics. Then students must be proficient in using different types of calculators. However, in school education, in early primary education, we do not promote use of calculators or other gadgets, because in mathematics, if the students get used to of calculators, then they will not develop their skills of mathematics. they would not be able to compute by themselves and they will be dependent on the calculators. To avoid this, in primary mathematics, we encourage mental arithmetics, use of mental skills to solve the problems and to do the basic arithmetics in maths. But with the passage of time in later classes, we gradually introduce gadgets to the students to make them easy with mathematics. Graphing, utilities, spreadsheets, calculators, computers, and other forms of electronic information technology are now standard tools for mathematical problem solving in science, engineering, business and industry, government and practical affairs. It means the basic tools of mathematics are not only used in the subject of mathematics, but it applies all over the daily life. It includes information technology, and information technology is everywhere in our surroundings, and mathematical problem solving tools are equally used in science, engineering, business and industry, government and practical affairs. You can point out and make a list of uses in these different areas, use of mathematics, you can point out the points. Hence, the use of technology must be an integral part of teaching, learning and assessment. However, facility in the use of technology shall not be regarded as a substitute for the student's understanding of quantitative concepts and relationships or for proficiency in basic computations. Again, what I have already taught you, that we should not taught the students that they should be dependent on the gadgets and use of technology, but they should be independent of the technology and they should be able to compute the basic maths without the use of any technology. However, we promote use of technology in higher classes to avoid the time lapse. Next objective, first objective of mathematics, mathematical education is mathematical problem solving. This should be an objective of the mathematics teaching, and a mathematics teacher should focus on developing mathematical problem solving skills among students in the classroom. Because if the problem solving skills are not being developed among the students in the mathematical classrooms, that means that mathematical classroom is not meeting the standards of teaching mathematics. Students will apply mathematical concepts and skills and the relationships among them to solve problem situations of varying complexities. Students also will recognize and create problems from real-life data and situations within and outside mathematics and then apply appropriate strategies to find acceptable solutions. Developing mathematical problem-solving skills among students include that they should gather data from real-life situations and other than mathematics, which belongs to different areas of daily life, and what they have learned in the mathematics classroom, if they are able to apply appropriate strategies and if they are able to find out acceptable solutions to different problems in the daily life situations, then we can say that the child has developed mathematical problem solving skills. And in order to accomplish this goal of developing mathematical problem solving skills, it is very important that students has already developed a good repertoire and a good repertoire of skills and strategies in order to solve the variety of problem types. It means that if the students has the students have basic knowledge and skills of mathematics, only then they will be able to apply these skills and strategies in solving the problems of mathematics. Basically, students enjoy and use when students enjoy and use math when the concepts they learn make sense to them. If they are developing understanding of the mathematics problems, then they will enjoy the maths. But if a student is not developing the concepts of maths, then they will not enjoy the teaching and learning of mathematics. Investigating problems builds students' understanding of concepts. It also allows students to apply their math skills in everyday situations. So, a mathematical teaching should be based on the development of understanding of concepts. In your child's math classroom, the students tackle math problems that are appropriately challenging, explore many different approaches to solve problems. It means sorry for disturbance. We will start again. We were talking about development of problem-solving skills among students, and here we discussed two points: that if the students are developing concepts of mathematics, then they will enjoy the teaching and learning process of mathematics. And secondly, the students should be able to tackle all the math problems which are appropriately challenging. And appropriately challenging, we mean that the challenging problems should be according to the age and grade of the students. Like if you are teaching to the grade 2, the problems of mathematics you are posing to the students should be according to the age level and intellectual abilities of the students who belong to grade 2. Secondly, the students should be able to explore many different approaches to solving problems. Like if you are posing a question of mathematics to the class, the students should be able to think about, to reason about the ways, different ways, more than one ways to solve those problems, and then they should be able to choose the best appropriate method to solve that problem. If your students are not able to list different strategies and different approaches to solve a single problem, it means they are most probably rote memorizing mathematics. Slide. We have already discussed these three points. Students will use the language of mathematics, including specialized vocabulary and symbols to express mathematical ideas precisely. So, mathematical communication is basically use of different signs and symbols of mathematics in daily life conversations with the teachers, with the students, and overall in the classroom. If a mathematical classroom focuses on developing mathematical communication skills among the students, that would be a better maths classroom. And in order to develop these mathematical communication skills among the students, what teacher can use is representing, discussing, reading, writing, and listening to mathematics, and all these strategies will help the students to clarify their thinking and deepen their understanding of the mathematics being studied. And definitely, when your students will be able to think and deepen their understanding about the mathematics, they will use the concepts of mathematics and the vocabulary and symbols of mathematics in their daily communication. And again, this communication will be developed through different strategies like discussion about mathematical topics in the classroom, when we read about mathematics and writing, listening to the mathematics, ideas and concepts. This helps to develop mathematical communication skills among students. Once the students have developed their problem-solving skills, as we discussed in the previous objective of the mathematics education, this second objective is mathematical communication, and this is the very essential part of math, because if the student is able to think and reason about mathematics, the next important part is to, if the child is able to communicate his thinking and his reasoning to his peers and to his surroundings. And through this communication, students share and develop their understanding with each other. And over time, students learn to use this language precisely and effectively. In your child's math classroom, students participate in many conversations with the teacher and with other students, in which they ask students, share and clarify ideas, compare strategies, draw conclusions, and explain their reasoning. Here you can see, if you remember your mathematics classroom, when you were attending your school, most probably, because it is a common practice in Pakistan, that maths classroom is the most quiet classroom. There is very little conversation between teacher and students and among students about mathematics in the classroom when they are solving the questions. They only focus to learn mathematics instead of understand mathematics. What usually we follow the practice is the blackboard, use of blackboard. The teachers used to write down solve the problem on the blackboard, and students are supposed to just copy that problem on their notebooks. But what an ideal mathematical classroom requires: a healthy conversation between teachers and students, and among the students, teachers should use and enhance those type of teaching strategies in the classroom which involve different communications among students. Different strategies can be used in the classroom which enhance the communication skills among the students. Everyone's thinking is valued and considered. Communicate their math thinking orally and in writing. If a student is not able to communicate to his peers what he is learning about mathematics and what he is understanding about mathematics, then it means he is not grasping the concept exactly. Third major objective of mathematics education is developing mathematical reasoning among students. You all better know the concept of reasoning in your previous classes. Through your previous classes, I hope you all know about inductive and deductive reasoning. And this is the same reasoning skills which should be developed in the mathematical classrooms. Students will recognize reasoning and proof as fundamental aspects of mathematics. Students will learn and apply inductive and deductive reasoning skills to make, test, and evaluate mathematical statements and to justify steps in mathematical procedures. It means students in this mathematical classroom should know about solution of each and every step in a single problem. Like when they are solving a problem of mathematics, they should know what is happening in each step, like why they are doing addition first, followed by subtraction, and so on. Students will use logical reasoning to analyze an argument and to determine whether conclusions are valid or not. In addition, students will learn to apply proportional and spatial reasoning and to reason from a variety of representations such as graphs, tables, and charts. It means mathematics is not only about solving the traditional problems of mathematics, It also involves different representations of maths like graphs, tables and charts. The students should be able to explain graphs, tables and charts, and they should be able to explain the reason. Reasoning improving students need to be able to explain the reasoning behind a solution or choice of strategy. Like when you introduce any question to the students in your classroom, each and every child in your classroom should know different strategies to solve those problems, and he should have the capability to choose the best one way of solving that problem. They need to be able to answer the question, how do you know? The mathematics teacher should be asking this question in the classroom most oftenly. How do you know? Aapko kaise pata hai ki iska answer is tarike se solve karke nikala jayega. It means we provide the opportunity to the students to explain their thinking, their reasoning in the classroom, that how they think that this particular problem will be solved by using this particular strategy, and they should be able to defend their thinking and their reasoning in the classroom. In your child's math classroom, the students make predictions, test hypotheses, and explain their thinking. What these three points mean that even for a very simple question or problem, the students must have the ability to first predict the solutions, the way to find out the solution. The students should have the habit to develop predictions. For example, you can see in the given example, 7 plus question mark is equal to 12. This is very simple and basic question in the primary mathematics in the early grades. But for the grade of like grade prep or one class, it's quite difficult for a student to find out that what should be placed in the blank or in the place of question mark. The students should, when you pose like questions, the students should be able to give different answers and give different strategies to solve this question, and they should be able to then explain that why they think that it should be placed here, should be placed 5, and how do they come to know that their answer is 5. The next mathematical objective is mathematical connections. This is also an important objective of the mathematics. Students will relate concepts and procedures from different topics in mathematics to one another and see mathematics as an integrated field of study. You will be a very good, very successful mathematics teacher if the students of your class do not see, do not observe each and every unit of the mathematics as a separate entity. If your class is successful in integrating different units of mathematics, it means they are getting well the concepts of mathematics. Through the application of content and process skills, students will make connections between different areas of mathematics and between mathematics and other disciplines, especially science. Science and mathematics teachers and curriculum writers are encouraged to develop mathematics and science curricula that reinforce each other. Because connecting one discipline with all other disciplines makes it more meaningful and more enjoyable for the students. When they come to know that how mathematics can be used in different sciences and other different fields, it will be very interesting aspect of mathematics for the students, because mostly students see mathematics as a separate entity and they feel that math is only found in mathematics classroom. Students learn best when they can connect new concepts. Basically, here we discuss that connections, mathematical connections, means two types of connections. One is making connections between new knowledge and the skills and prior learning. This is also very important because the previously learned mathematics concepts should be engaged in the new classroom and they should be have a better connection with the new learning. The second connection is making connections between math and other subjects. This is also equally very important that the students should have should know about connections of math with all other disciplines and so that they can better understand mathematics. Here you can see different examples of mathematical connections. In first example, connecting new concepts to old concepts. Which decimal is equivalent to 12%? Which decimal is equivalent to 0.9%? So these you can use these types of questions in order to develop mathematical connections in the math classroom. Connected percents to rational numbers, reasoning that 12% means 12 divided by 100. Then connected the fraction to a decimal, 12 divided by 100 is equal to 0.12. 0.9% means 0.9 divided by 100, which converts to 0.009. So in this way, you can use the previous knowledge to explain your new concepts. The next mathematical objective is mathematics representation. Developing representations skills is important because if a child has developed basic concepts and concepts of mathematics, he should be able to represent his understandings. Students will represent and describe mathematical ideas, generalizations and relationships with a variety of methods. And what are these methods? Students will understand that representations of mathematical ideas are an essential part of learning, doing and communicating mathematics. Students should move easily among different representations like graphical, numerical, algebraic, verbal and physical. These are the types of mathematical representations. If a student is getting the ideas of different problems of mathematics, he can either represent its solutions in graphical forms, he can use different numerical forms to represent the concepts of mathematics, algebraic notations, verbally and physically, represent kiya ja sakta hai maths ko. And recognize that representation is both a process and product. And students should understand this concept that representation is not only a single process, but it is both a process and a product. Because, for example, if you are drawing a graph of numerical data, it means the graph of what you are drawing is a product. And what you can see is math concepts and procedures can be represented in many different ways. Using a variety of ways to represent a concept or procedure leads to deeper understanding. Math manipulatives like physical objects students can manipulate are particularly valuable tools to allow students to represent their thinking. They allow students to explore abstract concepts in a hands-on, concrete way. A student's concrete representation can also give the teacher useful insight into the student's thinking. And if you are in the math classroom, your child should use a wide variety of learning tools to explore and represent math concepts and use graphs, tables, words, physical and digital models, drawings, numeric and algebraic expressions and equations when solving the problems. Here we have finished our objectives of teaching mathematics. We will have a quick review what we have done so far. We have talked about different objectives of teaching mathematics. First one was developing problem-solving skills among students in the mathematical classroom. Then we have to teach students then that how they can reason in the mathematics classroom. Similarly, mathematical connections, then mathematical representations, and finally mathematical communications. These are basically objectives of teaching mathematics in the classroom. Now we will discuss different sample questions that being a maths class teacher, when you are focusing on any one objective of the teaching mathematics, you can pose these questions in your classroom. First one is, we will discuss problem solving. And what are the sample questioning for problem solving skills? It involves, first one is, what is happening in this problem? What am I asked to find? What do I know that I can use to solve this? So these are the three questions you as a teacher of mathematics are supposed to inculcate in the brains of your students. Your mathematics students, when you are going to represent or going to pose a problem in the classroom, when you are giving any question in the classroom to solve to the students, you should teach your students that the first question should come in their mind, that what is happening in this problem. Next, the students should be taught to ask to themselves, what am I asked to find out? The students should know that what is being asked in this problem. Then the third strategy is, what do I know that I can use to solve this? So, in the third one question, the students should be able to find out the solutions, the possible solutions from his previous knowledge, which you have already taught to those students. The student should be able to find out the best possible solution which he has already in his brain. Now, the second objective is reasoning and proving. And being a mathematics teacher, you should inculcate these two questions in the brains of your students. Why does this make sense? Like when you have posed a question in the math classroom, your students should be thinking like, why does this make sense? And the other question they should ask themselves, how do I know my solution is right? It means the students should be able to analyze the solution, that whether I am going for to choose a solution is right or wrong. Sample questioning for the third objective of mathematics education, connecting. This concept reminds me of this problem is similar to these two types of questions reflect that the students are able to connect mathematics in the classroom with his previous knowledge and what he has already learned in the classroom. Next, sample questioning for representing. Representing, what does this diagram tell me? What equation can I use to show this? It means these type of questions are showing that if your student is able to answer these questions, he is using the representing skills of mathematics. So if you are giving the students a chart in the class, a pie chart, and if the student is immediately thinks about that what this diagram is telling about me, what this diagram is telling to me, it means he is very using well the representing skills of mathematics. Next, last sample questions are for communicating. How can I explain my strategy? Here is how I figured this out. It means if the student is able to answer the questions and explain the questions, explain his strategies, which he has used to answer the questions of mathematics. So these were the sample questions against each objective of teaching mathematics. लास्ट में मैं आपको इस सारे को समराइज करूंगी ताकि आप इसको ज्यादा बहुत अच्छे तरीके से इसकी कॉन्सेप्ट को अंडरस्टैंड कर सकें. व्हाट वी हैव डन सो फार इन दिस लेक्चर इज दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड डिफरेंट फाइव ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टीचिंग मैथमेटिक्स. बीइंग अ मैथ्स टीचर यू शुड हैव इन योर ब्रेन दीज फाइव ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टीचिंग मैथमेटिक्स. लाइक व्हेन यू आर स्टैंडिंग इन योर मैथ्स क्लासरूम तो आपके जहन में ये होना चाहिए कि मेरे स्टूडेंट्स के इस मैथ्स की क्लासरूम का मेरा ऑब्जेक्टिव ये है कि मेरे स्टूडेंट्स के अंदर इस ये सारे जो स्किल्स हैं ये डेवलप हो सके. दे शुड बी एबल टू कनेक्ट मैथ्स विद द प्रीवियस नॉलेज एंड विद द डेली लाइफ. दे शुड बी एबल टू रिप्रेजेंट देयर थिंकिंग इन मैथमेटिकल वेज. दे शुड बी एबल टू कम्युनिकेट their mathematical concepts. They should be able to communicate their mathematical thinkings to their peers and to their teachers. And similarly, the students should be able to solve different problems in different situations. I hope you understand this lecture.